A town in the heart of Palestine with a unique historical past and significant contemporary present. A town with a great sense of pride in its family roots and cultural heritage, as much as in its status as a center of learning and a focal point of Palestinian national struggle for independence. Throughout the Palestinian history, Bir Zeit's name was always synonymous with the Palestinian national struggle for independence. It was in Bir Zeit where the late national Palestinian leader, Abdul Qadir al-Husseini, chose to have the headquarters of his revolt against the Zionist plan to create a Jewish homeland in Palestine in the 1940s. In more recent time, Bir Zeit was always at the center stage of the Palestinian resistance against the Israeli occupation. Not only did Bir Zeitis embrace and take an active part in the resistance, where many got jailed or martyred, some Bir Zeitis assumed leadership roles as founders of the Palestine Liberation Organization and as members of its executive committee. Education was equally as important, where Bir Zeit was always considered a beacon of learning and higher education. Bir Zeit College was established in 1924 as the only educational institution, grades 1 through 12, where many Palestinians and non-Palestinians seeking a high standard and quality education came to enroll. In 1974, Bir Zeit University was established as the first national Palestinian university that offered bachelor degrees in humanities, science, commerce, and engineering. Today, many Palestinian leaders and successful entrepreneurs in politics, medicine, science, commerce, and other fields have either attended Bir Zeit College or are graduates of Bir Zeit University. Bir Zeitis trace their roots to the Arabian Peninsula. According to historical accounts, it was from Yemen in the Arab Peninsula where present-day Bir Zeitis started their migration trek north as Bedouin tribes, first settling in Jordan and then moving west to Palestine. Tribal feuds and disputes between different clans shifted the early Bir Zeiti migrants between different villages until finally they settled in Bir Zeit around the year 1700. Today, Bir Zeit is inhabited by six different clans. They are the original clans who settled in Bir Zeit. Four are Christian clans who are descendants of one patriarch known by the name Nimr. Two are Muslim clans. Other families also settled in Bir Zeit as refugees who fled the Arab-Israeli War of 1948. Harsh political and economic conditions during the Turkish rule of Palestine and the subsequent events which led to the creation of Israel have prompted many Bir Zeitis to emigrate. The first wave of immigration took place in the early part of the 20th century, and most Bir Zeiti immigrants settled in North America, while some settled in South America. During the early part of the British rule of Palestine after the collapse of the Ottoman Empire, Palestine experienced a period of relative peace and economic stability. Some immigrants, homesick, took advantage of the improved conditions and returned to their homeland. Little or no immigration happened during this period. Not until after the 1967 war, which led to the Israeli occupation of the West Bank, that the second wave of immigration took place. Immigration accelerated during the 60s and 70s, where most immigrants chose to go to North America, while others chose the Arab Gulf countries and Jordan. Today, the USA and Canada are home to the largest Bir Zeiti communities outside Bir Zeit. Jordan comes second. Scattered and separated from each other, Bir Zeitis in the diaspora started to look for ways to keep connected and to stay in touch with each other. Forming an association to facilitate this goal started to take shape, And on November 18, 1987, Beer Zates in Southern California celebrated the formation of the first chapter of the society, and a new board of directors was elected. An interim national executive committee was formed and elected Suhail Cassis as the first society president. In November 1988, the Northern California chapter was established. The Washington chapter was established in 1989, the New York chapter was established in May of 89, and the Texas chapter in 1995. The first national board of directors of Beer Zates Society was formed on October 20, 1990, and elected Dr. Musa Nasser as the society's president. Today, the national organization of Beer Zates Society consists of 5 chapters and 2 groups. Beer Zates Society's chapters play a very vital role in helping Beer Zates stay connected with each other. They do this by hosting local events to bring Beer Zates together and raise funds to support the various activities of the society. Beer Zates Newsletter, the official publication of Beer Zates Society, is published twice or 3 times a year with over 1,000 copies printed. Today, Beer Zates Newsletter consists of approximately 50 pages and reaches over 1,000 Beer Zates families in the USA, Canada, Australia, Europe, and other countries, as well as Jordan and Palestine. The newsletter remains the number one tool that keeps Beer Zates connected with each other and with their homeland. The Beer Zates website also plays a critical role in bringing Beer Zates together and provides an informative vehicle by which Beer Zates and non-Beer Zates can learn about Beer Zates and the Beer Zates Society. Beer Zates conventions are held every other year in different parts of the USA, where many Beer Zates are concentrated in big numbers. It was also held twice in Beer Zates and once in Jordan. Beer Zates come from all over the world to attend the conventions and renew their ties. In addition to being primarily social and cultural events, Beer Zates conventions have provided a platform to educate and inform Beer Zates about various topics and current events. They also feature many prominent figures who are invited as guest speakers and panelists to share their insights on such topics as politics, social justice, human rights, and others. In addition to being a social, educational, and cultural organization, Beer Zates Society remains focused on its mission as a charitable organization dedicated to helping needy Beer Zates and Palestinian families, students, and institutions. Over the years, Beer Zates Society's charitable programs have provided hundreds of thousands of dollars in financial assistance to Beer Zates institutions, such as Beer Zates Municipality, the Boys and Girls Club, Beer Zates Clinic, Beer Zates Orthodox Scouts, Beer Zates Club in Jordan, Beer Zates Schools, the Rosanna Foundation, and Beer Zates Senior Citizen Center. Beer Zeit Society also provided financial support for other projects such as bus shelters, a hearse, an ambulance, computer equipment, garbage containers, parks, the town cemeteries, and medical equipment. Beer Zeit Society Scholarship Program also plays a very vital role in helping many needy Beer Zeit students go to college and receive higher education. Since its inception in 1992, the program has provided thousands of dollars in financial assistance to needy Beer Zeit students in Beer Zeit. Currently, 18 needy Beer Zeit students receive scholarships annually. The Society's Scholarship Fund, which started with $3,000, has grown to over $63,000 and is continually growing thanks in large part to all the donors, the memorial funds, and scholarship fund sponsors who are the main source of funding to our scholarship program. Beer Zeit Society's strategic plan envisions a $1 million scholarship fund so that every Beer Zeit student can receive a scholarship. As we celebrate the 20th anniversary of the founding of the Beer Zeit Society, much has been accomplished during those past 20 years, thanks in large part to all the volunteers who donated time and money to keep this mission alive and strong. As in the words of some of those who founded Beer Zeit Society and were instrumental in the success during the past 20 years, much has been accomplished, but much more remains to be done as the Society's mission is ongoing in nature and never ends.
The health of Beer Zeit people in general. They helped to build, to clean Beer Zeit, to plant trees, to help the people who needed help.
I think they accomplished a lot. However, the extent of the accomplishment could have been more. It is just the resources have been very low as far as to be able to help.
Well, it helped the people of Beer Zeit in the diaspora to keep in contact with each other. They have the convention that comes in every couple of years where people got to see other people from Beer Zeit whom they hadn't seen for a while.
I'm pleased that the Society has established itself as one of the most important Arab American organizations. And I'm not saying this because I'm part of the Society, but because it has been recognized by other groups as a leading Arab American organization. But I think we have a long way to go and do more to achieve more objectives of our community.
Knowing what the Society wanted to do 20 years ago, yes, they did accomplish it. They made the glue, the Society became the glue that put the Beer Zeities together, and it glued them together. They get together, they start knowing each other, they have the scholarship program, they have the magazine, they have the convention. I think they did accomplish that.
Actually, the most remarkable thing is we succeeded to do a big reunion of the Beer Zeit people all over the world, and in the United States especially. That was a big accomplishment. It's a big focus for me personally, is the youth. Our youth is our investment, and we should really keep pushing that subject. We do quite a lot, but not enough for the youth. Without the youth, there's no continuation, and this is, again, should be our biggest investment.
One aspect, definitely. I mean, one of the things that we wanted to do for sure is to create a society that can sustain itself, that has its own systems, and it does not rely on people or individuals. I think that aspect of the society we've accomplished, I think the society right now can sustain itself and continue to function based on its original mission.
Society accomplished a lot of the goals set for the people in Beer Zeit and here. didn't complete that, but I think we are getting there. But at this time, it looks like, you know, we need more involvement of the new generation, who we have more, I think, people, new generation from Derziet born here than the people immigrated from Derziet.
Helping our people in Derziet and educating a lot of our young people in Derziet, I think that's a great accomplishment, and I would like to improve on that also. Creating jobs in Derziet for our young people to find jobs in Derziet, great job, keep the good work going for everyone, and I would like to thank everybody who put an effort in Derziet society.
20 years have passed. We have a very nice organization, very well run, and as a vehicle for Derziet community in the United States, it's I think we have achieved that aspect. Other aspect we need to achieve, we need to work on, yes, definitely.
Society had turned. I'm very happy for continuing for 20 years. I'm happy to see that Berzetis are still connected together due in large part to the efforts of Berzet Society. I'm extremely happy at our charitable program, which has been extremely successful in helping Berzet in the amount of over $500,000 in the past 20 years, and our scholarship program, which is doing a fantastic job in helping our needy Palestinian and Berzet students.
20 years have passed, many more years will come, and a new generation of young Berzetis will carry the torch. We owe it to our future generations to keep them connected with each other, to keep them aware of their cultural heritage and family roots. Let's keep Berzet in our hearts and in our minds. Let us keep the good work of helping Berzet and each other going. Congratulations, Berzet Society, on 20 years of success, 20 years of giving, 20 years of caring. Congratulations, Berzet.